All around us every day is data. And in some cases, this data is moving really fast and really with a lot of information. You know, in 2006, a phrase was coined, data is the new oil. And this mathematician really just kind of struck the nail on the head, because when you look at an enterprise and all the data that it generates and creates, using that data to make better informed business decisions is absolutely paramount in being a leader and an innovator in your area of the business. So just to give you an example, a 737 plane creates about 20 terabytes of data in just 1 hour of use. Now, a lot of that information can be fairly benign, but imagine, if you will, if you were faced and tasked with the problem of, we need to leverage all of this information, all of this data, and some of it is just voluminous. How do we do it? Well, let's talk about that. Today, we're going to be talking about streaming and data streaming concepts. And I'm going to talk first about an architecture for a streaming, streaming data in an enterprise. And then in a future video, we'll do a deeper dive on what really kind of happens underneath the covers. But first, let's get started. Okay, so in a streaming architecture, there are essentially three areas. First of all, you have an origin, and that's where the data actually comes from. Could be the sensor, could be a machine itself, could be anything that produces or emits data. And remember, this data is coming all the time and constant. Sometimes the origin is paired with a messaging system, for example, like MQTT technology, that allows that telemetry to get delivered to some other system. So we have an origin. The next thing we have is processor. The processor is actually a place where in the overall architecture where we take action and handle the data and try to, in some cases, trim it down. But in many cases, we try to understand what the story is with the data that we're given. Lastly is a destination. The destination is actually where we're going to land the data in this streaming architecture that can allow people who are consumers down the stream to leverage it and do it at their own pace. The key value point with a streaming architecture is to avoid the stale. So in a graph, you can see that if I were to plot where value is up here and time is down here, our graph for our data starts about here and then goes off like that. What we do with a streaming architecture is we try to capitalize on this right here. The ability to maximize our value in the lowest amount of time. And many call that real time, but it is essentially streaming. So let's dig in. So from an origin perspective, we're going to take that information, we're going to deliver that into a system, and so we're going to just essentially, we're just going to call this ingest. We're going to take that data from the origins, and then we're going to take it into our streaming analytics and streaming platform. The next thing is the processor. So in the processor, when you look at the things that happen, really the most typical things are, first of all, we're going to potentially filter. We're then next going to enrich. Then we're going to analyze. So in these three steps, what we have is an ability to take all this voluminous data at the speed that it's coming on the wire, and we're going to filter it to get rid of things that we're not interested in. We're going to add context, such as, where's this data coming from? What machine? What location? What is it currently in the business? What are the operations? All of that just, it doesn't come on the sensor. Actually, when the record arrives, most of the time, it's just going to have a timestamp and some rudimentary readings like temperature and pressure, something of that nature. What we need to add to it is, where is this coming from? Give me some context of what this sensor is actually attached to. This could be a vehicle. It could be your vehicle. And when we're looking at this, we need to actually kind of put it into context. Then the next step is we're going to analyze it. This is where we're going to apply machine learning, potentially traditional AI, maybe generative AI, but we're going to look at this and try to analyze the readings, whether they be temperature readings or pressure readings, over time, and try to find patterns. We'll try to find the patterns, either they're going up, they're going down, wherever we're interested in. Obviously, if we're looking at costs and money-related things, we want to make decisions when it's optimal for us to make a purchase so that the cost is down. But if we're operating a machine and the temperature is going up, that might be leading to a failure. So we want to get to that sooner rather than later. So once we analyze this information, we get context about what's the data telling us, what is happening in the data. Then lastly, we're going to take and we're going to egress that information for somebody else that might be interested in another area of the business. But overall, a streaming architecture contains a way for you to capitalize on maximum value. So we're doing this in real time at wire speed. As the data is coming across, we're ingesting it from the origins, we're processing it, filtering, enriching, and analyzing, and then we're egressing that points of interest. You know, I had a mentor tell me a long time ago about how companies had become data hoarders. We really, this is a system and an architecture that could help you prevent, really not be a data hoarder. You can avoid keeping, hundreds of thousands of records that have the same reading and just really only persist those records that have the anomaly or have the variant that are points of interest that could, really impact maybe a maintenance decision or an operations decision. So we're going to store the things that we're interested in for later use. Now, last point, how does this scale? What does this look like? So in many cases, you can have a processing engine that can, when we look at an instance of this, we can have, multiple numbers of engines scaled across different compute so that we're scaling horizontally to take in that amount of data so that we can keep up with the wire speed. In many cases, we're not talking about that level of data. We're just sort of able to scale to points where we have maybe, spikes in data. And so in that, the actual engine itself will scale out and have n number of process sections or n number of destinations or n number of receivers to take in from our origin data. Either way, we scale to meet the speed of the data so that we can always keep our eye on the North Star, which is maximizing the value in the real time that the data is emitted. Thanks for watching. I hope this was helpful.